many times, sometimes if the devil asks you to do something, or the Lord, excuse me, because the devil's fighting awful hard. But when the Lord asks you to do something, the devil comes like a mighty thing at you. Tells you you can't do it. He tells you that it ain't gonna work. Tells you not good, not for today. He tells you it ain't gonna touch somebody. It tells you it's not, you're not gonna do it today. But I serve notice on him. I may not get all rhythm and I may not get all notes, but I know who I serve. And I know that if anybody knows about the love of Jesus, the grace of Jesus, and the power of Jesus, it's me. And if there's anybody in here, you know about the love of Jesus, you know about the grace of Jesus, and you know about the power of Jesus. So you don't ever let anything. I may not get all the notes. I may not get all the rhythm. But I do know today that this song is for somebody. And if you don't get anything, you listen to the words. Because there's nothing like the love and the grace and the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. If anybody knows about the love of Jesus, took away my doubt. When I was struggling to find my place, I heard the sweet song said to me from the throne. It's a song.
Sorrows like sea billows roll. say, it is well, it is well with my soul, it is well.
And Lord, haste the day. so. Aren't you glad this morning that there is a knowing? I said, aren't you glad this morning that there is a knowing? Over the years, I've asked people, if Jesus comes in the next 5 seconds, where do you go? I don't know. Well, are you right or have you reached? I don't know. Listen, you can know. I said, there is a knowing today, and it can be well with your soul. A few months back, several months back now, in fact, you remember Chris that sat over here to my left. He's gone on to be a youth pastor for his father, had a motorcycle wreck, and actually passed away, I think, about seven different times throughout.
That's right.
He broke, I don't know, many bones in his body, and the doctor said he had never walked. Today he's walking, talking. He's a youth pastor at his church for his father. Just after that wreck, we'd gone to visit him. They transferred him to North Arkansas. And we walked in that room. Many of you know this story. We walked in the room. Some of the staff and I walked in, and he was laying in that bed. And before we walked in the room, the nurse was standing outside, and I just stopped her and I asked her, how's he doing? And she gave us a very grave report. She said he could still, at any moment, he could pass away. I walked in. He's laying in that bed. And I just leaned over to him. I said, Chris, you don't know me, and I don't know you, but we know your family. And we've come here today to see how you're doing. And I already know how you're doing physically. But my question to you today is, I want to know, how are you doing spiritually? I never gave him an opportunity to talk. And he looked up at me laying in that bed. And he said, preacher, he said, if Jesus comes today, I go to hell. And he said, but I want to change that. And we led him to Jesus, him laying right there in that bed. And I'm telling you, you can tell a difference just like that. And just months later now, he's called by God. I'm telling you, there is a knowing. I said, you have a knowing in your heart. Come on, if you lay your head down this afternoon and he comes, there's a knowing. Would you give the Lord a hand clap of praise one more time?